Audio is sick, scarecrow is sick, set design is sick. It's really, really improved from last year. It's so cool. Hello everyone, my name is Alex from Official AVF. Hope you're all well. And today you join me from a very overcast and a little bit rainy Thorpe Park here, finally being able to do a vlog for Fright Nights. Last time I came was opening day. It was incredibly hectic, very rainy. A bug just flew in my ear. It was a bit of a shambles of a day. Hello. I'm trying to do the vlog, but it's not working. We're gonna just roll with it anyway. We are at Thorpe Park. It's Fright Nights opening day. My name's Alex from Official AVF. It's very rainy, as you can tell from the umbrella.
Many hours later.
Hello. It's very wet.
And cold.
Yeah. It's coming up to 2 o'clock, I think, just after 2 o'clock, so Fright Nights officially starts in an hour. But I started off my day looking in the dome for the brand new merch, which I've actually purchased. I got the Fright Nights exclusive maze hoodie. I'm assuming it'll be on sale for the rest of the event, but get it if you're interested while stocks last. I'll put up some footage actually so you can see the front and the back design. It's very, very cool. And I also managed to get myself the Creek Freak Massacre wooden pin badge as well, which I would put on a lanyard, but I don't have one on me today. It's another solo trip, sadly, but the very special someone, Lucy, who was in Trailers Breakout of Bozos in June, July, over summer, over at Carnival, has now joined the Crows of Mork and Neddo. I'll put in a photo of her, just so you guys know what she looks like, so if you catch her, then be sure to say hello, be nice to all the scare actors, show some respect, they are people under the masks. We're going to get started, as Fright Night starts in about an hour. I've got some mazes booked for later on, but who knows, I might do a ride or two now. Other than that, we do not do rides at Fright Nights. So yeah, let's jump right into it. I've waffled enough, so let's jump right into it and start the day at Thorpe Park Fright Nights. Just had a fair while since I've done a vlog segment actually. You last saw me just before the event started. It is now, I think, 4 o'clock, coming up to 4 o'clock. Yeah, just about 4 o'clock. And I'm over in Birthday Bash now. But we're gonna see some of the actors and hopefully the stage show, which is at 1:30. But then I've got some maze bookings as well, so maybe we'll catch it, maybe we won't, or maybe we'll catch a later one. But the Crows were absolutely fantastic this year. It's always great seeing them on the bridge and running around the park. As I mentioned before, Lucy, who was previously in Trailers Breakout at Bozos, has now joined the Crows of Mork and Neddo as well. And they roam for a good hour and a half from 3 o'clock to like 4:30, and then they go into the scare zone, which we'll do later on when it gets a bit darker. It's been a fantastic day so far at Fright Nights. The weather's kind of held off, it's been a little bit drizzly, but it's been okay. We're gonna head into the next attraction now, so I guess we'll see you when we're over there. Thank you.
lock on now.
This one's got a key on it, so...
it's a top corner.
It is why it is paramount that this performance goes ahead without a hitch. And that's where you'll come in, you see. Applause is a very important part of the show, sir. I would appreciate applause throughout the performance today, okay? Thank you all for coming to my birthday. No. We'll give that another go, okay? That wasn't the best. Thank you all for coming to my birthday. No! If we don't get this right, it'll be my head on the chopping block. And I do have the head of my predecessor to prove it.
Nothing in the past, the new generation.
Let your kids, what's it?
A fair bit has happened since the last vlog segment. As you can see there, we ran into Digital Dan, and of course Caleb from Launch Reality, but I'll leave the link in the description below, and I'll put obviously the name there. So be sure to go check those guys out. They make fantastic content, and you know they're really good content creators to go support, so go ahead and do that. Link in the description below once again. But yeah, I have just been through trailers. Of course, Breakout of Bozos was the kind of overlay during Carnival. The new revamped Super Spark Cinema was fantastic there. Some different posters for the movies. Like the Beyond the Chair was called Beyond the Chair, The Checkup. And like some other movie names and stuff, and the character costumes have changed, as well as the props and stuff, as well as even the sets as well. So it's definitely worth a run through. It's not just a rehash of what was there last year, but now I'm heading over to Creek Freak Massacre, just beyond that way, through Old Town, and obviously of course the Project Exodus construction zone, so maybe we'll see something going on, but I'm going to be probably on my own for Creek Freak Massacre, so once again, we're going to head over that way for a great run through in one of the scare mazes this year, and then afterwards it's survival games. I've booked them pretty close to each other, so very excited. So let's jump right into it. Let's go over to Creek Freak Massacre.
Right, that turned that witch in, and we should have turned her in because she was a witch, right?
Don't go in there, it's not safe in there.
Where do you want me to go? I'm gonna go right.
finally, going back into Creek and to the close of Mocking Meadow. Creek Dream Massacre was fantastic. I'll let you know my full thoughts afterwards. But we're heading in now. Hopefully I don't get a vlog bomb. But we will see. I think I have a follower. Musical statues or something. That was awesome. I love this scare zone. I know in the daylight it doesn't do it justice, but it's absolutely fantastic in any light situation. Audio is sick, scarecrows are sick, set design is sick. I know I wasn't talking much in that clip, I'm trying to get a lot of footage, but it's really, really improved from last year. It's so cool. It's starting to get a little bit darker now. There's a lot of red light around. Definitely have to come back here through night time. There's some like that. I can't even tell if they're real or not. And at night time it is way, way, way worse. Much scarier. Like this one. At night time it completely blends in. There's so much smoke and stuff around. It's awesome. After having a very, very fun run through on Creek Freak Massacre, that was honestly, my full thoughts are, in a sentence, it was absolutely fantastic, as I've been saying with everything here. I got split up, first of all, in the pre-show, I got split up into Badwood, I think, the crawl space, which is the first time I've ever actually been put in the crawl space. And then I got split up again, kind of later on, got mixed with another group. And I went through, I think, Goodwood again, in the chainsaw maze, strobe maze part. But now it's a little bit later in the day, coming up to 6 o'clock now. Of course, with the sunset in front of me, which makes the Thorpe Park skyline look absolutely beautiful. There was a shot there just previously. But now I'm finally going to head over to the Swan Island and get on survival games. Because Creek Freak Massacre e-stopped earlier. And I kind of wandered around a bit. And obviously that was the next maze I had to do. So I'm going to head to Survival Games now, seeing as I've done both trailers and Creek Freak Massacre, which were both incredible mazes. So hopefully the trend continues, and we'll see you over at Survival Games on Swarm Island. So, night is falling on the island like no other. I've just been through Survival Games and the swarm is ripping around behind me. It looks absolutely beautiful. There was a really nice sunset earlier on. But Survival Games, wow. Going through on my own was something different. I knew I was going to get split up anyways, but there was someone, I think I know who it is, that was in the pre-show, and they put me in a cage with someone. They had enough, I guess they didn't have enough space for one cage per person. But that was really, really fun. I got split up again. You can tell I'm kind of losing my voice now. I got split up a few times. I was kind of guided in circles. I got pushed around by actors to guide me in a different way. And then I ended up winning. I don't know how. I just got in a chamber and then the cast was like, congratulations, you won. So I left, got chased. Well, I ran out of the maze because there's that kind of CO2 burst like they have in trailers and Creek Freak Massacre. Other than that, all around, that was a fantastic maze, as with the many other, the two other mazes here, they've all been fantastic. So, full marks for me, it's been very, very fun. But now, because it's getting darker, we're going to head over to the Crows of Morking Meadow once again. Probably will do more than once in the night, because it's only just beyond 6 o'clock, I think. So, who knows, I might go on a ride, I might stop somewhere to eat, I doubt I'll go on a ride, but I don't know. We'll see what other attractions we get up to, so we'll see you over there.
You go by, but something didn't move out of the corner.
Rehearsal, so make sure you're ready, losers. You do not want to upset Principal Apollo any more than you have done today.
Amity and Lycanthorpe High, this is your principal speaking. This is enough. Can you not put your differences aside for once? If you don't stop this right now, graduation is cancelled.
Hello. We're vlogging now. Yeah, if you want. Hello.
I am the light.
Wow. We're vlogging. We've just been through, we've just seen the Amity show, and of course, the wonderful, thank you, been joined. We've got Caleb from Launch Reality, Dan from Digital Dan, and Sam Costello from
Dan
Sam Costello.
Digital Dan.
As if it's a team.
Dan, I thought you were struggling with digital.
It is.
Yeah, I thought you guys... Give me some opinions on this year's Fright Nights.
Okay, I'll take over from here. Best ride in the dark was Stealth, because it's the only one we did. Best maze was Creep Freak, because Dan had an accident.
Yeah, and then he got us on Stealth for free. But I say for free, without
I don't know
to,
if I can
without
say
having
that.
To queue.
You can't say that.
We don't know if he can say that. He didn't have an accident.
I did have an accident, and as you can see, I killed myself on Creep Freak. I can't say that either.
Oh, no.
Okay, let's go back. And Dan didn't have an accident on anything today. Everything went so smoothly. He did like survival games though.
Oh, that has been a really good Fright Nights. Thoroughly enjoyed all of the mazes. The scare zones, like, it's a really strong year. Still can't wait for more stuff. I don't know what I'm saying.
Wait a minute.
And now...
Well, no, wait, what's that?
Oh, okay. And now it's time for Death Doors.
Oh, try.
Locksmith, keeper of keys. Here in my workshop, I handcraft the keys and doorways that unlock gateways to your worst nightmares. I will unleash evil within as I feed off your terror. I wonder which door is hiding your worst nightmare. Let legacy begin. We'll be right back.